Ms. Transformers 96 here with another video. I'm going to be talking about some newly shown Hot Toys from San Diego Comic-Con this year. Now, this is kind of an interesting video for me because usually what happens is that photos start leaking from just people at the event, you know, and then we start getting some images. Usually starts off with blurry, then progressively get a little better, and then, of course, by the time the event's in full swing, we get, like, high-definition images from Hot Toys themselves and Sideshow and things. But Sideshow, I guess, has decided not to go with that and just straight off the bat give us a good shot of all the figures, or at least what appears to be the majority of the Hot Toys figures on display. So we basically had them all at once, one good photo of each of them. So now, as more photos come out, we get more angles, possibly some other figures are shown, just because maybe Sideshow didn't take pictures of all of them, things like that. I will be making more videos going in depth of these characters, but for now that we have one good shot of a bunch of the characters out on display, I'm doing a video for Marvel, a video for DC, a video for Star Wars, just talking about the figures that I find the most interesting that were shown, and then I'm going to do a separate video just talking about Vulture, because I'm pretty into that figure, so I want to talk about him by himself. But as far as the things shown from Marvel, there were some cool things. Of course, my favorite is Vulture, but he's getting his own video, like I just mentioned. But of the other things, these would be the three that I find the coolest. And what's so cool, and what I'm actually just realizing right now, is that all three of these characters are African-American. That's pretty nice when, you know, a studio like Marvel, a big comic book studio, and, you know, like, the biggest franchise that there is, the three, like, coolest figures that are shown are all people of color. That's wonderful for the genre and the industry. But anyway, these three figures are very cool. All three of these have not been shown before in any capacity. Winter Soldier, of course, was there too, but he's been shown before in other photos, and so was the Outrider and things. But these are three completely new figures, which is very nice. Starting on the left here, we have Shiri, which is great. This is, of course, Black Panther, T'Challa's younger sister. She's a fan favorite character. I think she really stole the show for a lot of people in the Black Panther film. Figure wise, I think she looks quite good. I can't tell about the arms. The arms look like they are just rubber, which is definitely disappointing in my opinion. Again, I'm not into the rubber. I think that it will deteriorate, and although it looks slightly better, it just hinders articulation completely and, you know, won't last. So I'm not a big fan of that personally, but I think the figure looks nice. I like the fact that she does come with the blaster cannons, of course. Those are very unique, and the weapon that she uses in the film, so I'm glad that those are showcased. She even uses them in Infinity War as well. And then I think that the head sculpt actually looks really good. You know, obviously we're only getting one shot angle here, but I think that does look like a good head sculpt. I think the hair looks excellent, really well detailed in there. But face sculpt wise, I do think that it does resemble the actress for sure. I definitely want to see some more images from different angles to, you know, say exactly how good it is. But I think it does look quite good from this angle at least. In the middle here we have T'Challa on his throne, which is very cool. It's nice to get just a T'Challa figure. That's something that we don't get often, really. Iron Man is the only character, I think, that has, like, that has warranted a figure of just himself without his costume. I guess the only other time they did that was with Steve Rogers in the in that two-pack that came one costume and then one without. But anyway, it's nice to see him just in his kind of royal garb. I will say that the figure itself doesn't look great. The head sculpt looks really good. I'm sure it's the same head sculpt as the Black Panther figure that's coming out later. But the figure itself looks a little odd. I think that the feet don't look the best. They look very toyish. And then the way that the clothes are hanging aren't very natural. I hope that they add some more weight to them, or get a different material in there, something more velvety, to make it drape nicely, because something like Zod's cape hangs so well. It's one of the best hanging capes I've seen. So it would be nice if they can get, like, Zod's cape in there, just to you know, have that lay a little bit better, because it does look quite odd the way it is right now. Because it is really poofy. But the throne itself I do think looks cool. You could also put Killmonger in it. However, we don't. I mean, Killmonger never sits in the throne, just in his Golden Jaguar costume. And that's the only version of Killmonger we're going to get. But if you have, you know, if you want to do a custom, of course we're going to get an official Killmonger head sculpt with that figure, so you could put together a nice costume for that throne. I think it would be very cool. And then War Machine from Infinity War, I think looks very nice. I never really, like, paid close attention to his look in Infinity War, so this gives me a nice look at his costume. It looks like a more techno, like, aggressive suit compared to his Civil War one, because basically it's a Civil War one, but just with sharper edges, not as much rounded things. It's more just sharp and structured, and then it has just more more weapons on it, essentially. You know, you didn't think it could get any more, but it looks like they did just definitely intensify it, which is very cool. I did sell my War Machine figure. I decided that I didn't need it, and this one does look excellent, but I don't think I'm going to purchase it just because I don't really need a War Machine in my collection. If it was plastic, to be honest, I probably would get it, but I'm not a big fan of the diecast, so I think I'm going to skip it. But overall, here's the three, you know, most interesting Marvel figures, aside from Vulture, that were shown so far from Hot Toys at Comic-Con. Those are my thoughts on them. Love to hear what you guys think of them, and I will be talking about the rest of the Marvel figures as we get more, you know, better images of them, and not right now in the kind of preview stage. But let me know what you guys think of these, and thanks so much for watching.